So it was something that came as a surprise for many CFL fans as the league has entered into discussion with the XFL down south. Not so much for our CHCH sportscaster, the man who heads up Three Down Nation, Justin Dunk, who has woken up early and joins us this morning. Morning, pal. Why were you not surprised by this?
Because I had heard that it was going on for a few months. It was surprising to me, though, Timmy, that they came out and announced essentially that they were talking. So I feel like there's much more going on behind the scenes than we're being told right now.
Do you think it was just put out, like floated out there to gauge opinion on both ends?
I think it was a little bit of a litmus test. I asked Randy Ambrosi that yesterday in a chat that I had with him. He said it wasn't designed that way. But to me, that's the reason I feel it was floated out there, to see how much hype they could create together and if it was worth going forward.
Okay, what did you get from the commissioner when you were talking to him? Anything?
Well, to be honest, yeah, overall not much. But the key part of it that he did let slip, and I didn't see anywhere else, is that he expects a better financial outcome if a partnership happens with the XFL. And from what I've been told, Timmy, is that the CFL needs a financial backer to get back on the field in 2021. The key is, if that's the XFL, what does the CFL have to give up in the future?
Is it for this season, or are we looking into the future, or we don't know?
If the XFL is involved in terms of playing games with those teams, that's going to be for 2022. But from what I've gathered, the financial aspect of it, which obviously The Rock brings to the table with his fortune that he has, could be to help get the league back on the field this year and then maybe have an interlocking schedule or discuss what could be possible in 2022 and beyond.
Okay, for any of our viewers that don't know, what is the XFL, Doug?
So essentially, the XFL was created back in 2001 by Vince McMahon, who is the all-everything for what used to be the WWF and now is the WWE, World Wrestling Entertainment. A lot of it was tied to wrestling back in 2001. They only played one season, didn't get back on the field again until 2020, when Vince Young tried to distance it from the wrestling aspect. They played five games because of COVID-19. It got shut down. So The Rock purchased all of the assets, including eight franchises, for $15 million. That's where they are now.
Right. And so it is different than the CFL, where everybody has its own, each team is owned by a certain entity, where the XFL is an umbrella under that group, which includes Dwayne The Rock Johnson?
Exactly. It would essentially be referred to as central ownership with The Rock and his partner Danny Garcia. And in the CFL, you have the three different structures. In Hamilton, people well know there's one singular owner in Bob Young. You have the community ownership, and then you have the MLSCs and the Calgary Sports and Entertainments of the world.
So then how is it, it's got to be so hard, we only got a minute, but how it's got to be so hard to bring all those voices together in this. Would they be on calls with the XFL? They were made aware of this, that Randy was talking to outside sources like the XFL?
When you say they, who do you refer to? The owners?
I refer to the owners and the board of governors.
Yes, and to me, the telling statement was Bob Young yesterday saying that our focus is on 2021 and this news is nice. And I asked to talk to Bob Young exclusively. I asked to talk to Scott Mitchell. They were not made available. So if you read into that a little bit, Young is going to want the focus on 2021 and not this hype that's surrounding the XFL negotiations.
Because the Grey Cup is in this town in November, and hopefully that happens. Hey, good job on this. Glad you're on our team.
Me too, man. Work. Love you guys over there.
Keep up the good work, Doug. We're going to take a break. We're going to pay some of our bills. We'll be back after this.